Welcome, everyone. Can everyone hear me? I hate mics, but I've been told I need to use them. My name is Alita Wilson. I'm the Executive Director of Pentangle Arts. This will be Pentangle's 21st annual Mozart concert. We have two more concerts in our classical series. One takes us from fall and one takes us into winter. Next weekend, we're pleased to host Leslie Stroud and Matthew Odell, who will perform old and new world works, world sonatas for flute and piano. And then, of course, into the beginning of winter, the Messiah Sing returns here again December 9th at Our Lady of the Snows. I'd like to thank Father Mike, who is somewhere back there, for hosting. The Messiah and the Mozart concert honors Father Gallagher, the priest here for many years, who founded both concerts. So I'd like a little applause and recognition that we are trying to keep this going. I would also like to thank our sponsors, Gail and Alan Doherty, Carl and Chingwing Taylor, and the hosts for our musicians, Marisa Serafina, Charles D'Ambrosio, Fred Hunt, and Mary McVeigh. Thank you. And now please join me in welcoming our musicians tonight, led by Scott Woolweaver, John Lindsay, Karen Kadaverick, and Andrew Price.
Thanks, everyone. You guys can come up while the musicians are getting settled. I'll tell you just a little bit about each of the works that we're going to play this afternoon. The oboe quartet was a commission from a Swiss oboist. And Andrew says that's why the fourth movement contains yodeling. So you'll hear the oboe to a great extent imitating yodeling. And there's actually some feeble attempts in the viola part, but just so you know, there is a connection there. We find the pieces today are laid out chronologically. The oboe quartet is the earliest piece. The Ave Verum is the latest piece, but already we find with the oboe quartet, Mozart at the full height of his expressive powers and his management of musical form. The slow movement, the second movement is, a lot of people think when Mozart was writing a slow movement, he was writing an aria, and if so, this is really one of the most beautiful arias without words. The last movement is a form called a rondo, which means there's a main tune that keeps coming back. So the form is A, B, A, C, A, D, A. I call it the musical club sandwich, where the A is the bread and all the others are the things in between the bread. Mozart ended probably 90% of his chamber music with this type of movement. And in fact, the last movement of the trio is also a rondo. The string trio is Mozart's only piece for violin, viola, and cello. And after he wrote his last, what turned out to be his last three symphonies in 1885, he turned to chamber music and he gave us several viola quintets, which are pieces for string quartet and extra viola. And Mozart played the viola himself the latter half of his life, and he enjoyed being in the middle of the ensemble where he felt like he was running things from the inside out. So oftentimes when he wrote a piece of chamber music, he had himself in mind for playing the viola. And in fact, in this piece, he was on viola for the premiere of the work at a house concert. He was a real trendsetter with this piece, really pushing the limits of each individual instrument. Technically, it's you don't see it on programs very often. We played it here about 12 years ago, and I think none of us has played it since. It's notoriously difficult and notoriously complex, and you feel notoriously naked when you're playing it. He plumbs the depths of expression from deepest, darkest despair to absolute ecstasy. And in many ways, he was setting the stage for future composers like Beethoven with his expressive expressiveness and lyricism of Schubert. So I'm sure that future composers studied this and many other chamber works of Mozart. In fact, one of Beethoven's earliest pieces, the Opus 8, written when he was a teenager, is a serenade that follows the same movements as this Divertimento of Mozart. So undoubtedly Beethoven was aware of this piece. The Ave Verum is a beautiful motet known probably to most of you. It was found in the tablet that he wrote the last opera, The Magic Flute. It was found in the same tablet, and at the time Mozart was in Prague, so we think it was probably intended as a gift to one of the local churches when Mozart was producing his last opera in Prague. So we hope you join us in singing Ave Verum. I think you all have the words. Every year I beg for some harmony, so sing out. After we do our thing up here, it'll be your turn. Thank you all for coming, and we hope you enjoy the performance this afternoon.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Now it's your turn. We'll play this through once so you can hear how the tune is, and then there's a two-measure introduction. Hope you'll know when we come in.